So one thing we can do to enhance the chart, so make it look not very default anymore, is to illustrate the categories. So we have three categories over here. The way to illustrate them is to add icons. So why I would just put here icons, like pick them corresponding to the content. Sometimes it's easy when you have topics like, I don't know, what kind of sector or what kind of product is it, a computer, is it a car, then finding a specific icon for that is easier. Sometimes it's harder, like in this more abstract terms, like how to express the capital expenses versus personal expenses. So, but if you are familiar with our designs in every presentation which we share on Infodiagram, usually there is a set of icons which is so you can get a slide with icons which are related to the topic. So if you are speaking about financial reports, here you have the different financial icons like dollars, money in percentage, shopping, some just percentage sign. So these things you can just simply take, copy, and put on your slide like I did here. So to illustrate your categories or the overall chart or the trend. So just copy it. You can change the color. These are the outline icons which look more elegant. So you need to change the color, you need to go to change of the shape, outline and its color. So I can make it green or whatever color I like. Also, if you don't have much time, just put icons. If you have more time, you can play with putting icon inside some shape so it's more integrated. So, for example, you can just create a circle with a shift. Then you will, if you have all the shapes, the circle will be this, it will be circle, not oval. So the same height and width will be there. And I can just put it back. Oops, where's my icon? Ah, it has the same color. So just need to grab icon and make it, for example, white. Put it in the center, and this way I can create nice visualization, additional illustration with the icon. However, here are some other ideas how you can put them. So you can put them either in circle, either in this kind of shapes. You can either try to create them from scratch. These are shapes from PowerPoint. These are just the pentagon shapes. Or you can get these shapes from the deck, which we are going to share with you, which are part of our other templates. So we have already pre-designed the graphics over here. So you can change the color, change the position, change the inner content. For example, for a commentary field here, or if you want to show a specific point on a chart, this kind of teardrop is a nice shape to use. So this way you can enhance chart by illustrating categories. Next thing you can do is to add, for example, you can group these categories together by putting the light gray rectangle in the background. But with every element you add, you should remember about the visual hierarchy. So to keep the readability and the meaning of your chart, you should realize that there are parts which you want to highlight. So in our case, this is this orange color here. So this is the most important part, and I'm going to use one color just for that. Then I have some information level. So this is the other value which I'm going to compare it to. So last year values. For illustration, I have something even lighter, and for background, I have the most lighter color to be used. So remember when choosing colors to that there is some visual hierarchy, and that actually will also help your audience to focus on things you want them to focus on. And that was also one of the mistakes which I mentioned in the beginning. Then how to ensure that there is a focus on one thing. So using visual hierarchy is one way to do it. Additionally, you can, if it's one specific value, you can just show with arrow, a little bit arrow or some oval that, okay, these numbers are somehow suspicious or something I want you to focus on. So you can either create this kind of graphics with a heading oval, or for example, rectangle with rounded colors. where you can change the roughness over here and just make this one with outline color and without any filling. Maybe make outline a bit white, heavier. So, and this way you can have simple marker you can use, or you can use these kind of handwritten shapes, which are also part of the deck which we are going to share with you. So these are the shapes you can just copy and put on a on your chart. You can make them bigger, you can change their color with the shape fill. So that's another way. And one more thing which I want to address here is that when you are having presentation with the data chart, if you are speaking, if you are presenting it in a spoken form, okay, you can say, okay, compare these two values, there is something happening there. However, if you're going to send this presentation to someone, it's good to write your main meaning. What's the meaning of this chart? So to put it in a literally in a sentence on a slide. So for example, like we did here, we compare why this is lower and this is not lower. So we explain what's the value, what's the situation. And one way how to do it, you can just, if you have too busy slide and no place to put longer text, then you can just put a rectangle with some transparent settings. So transparency of the rectangle, it can be set over here. If I go to format shape, this window will open, and here I can set up the transparency of the shape. So if it's there's no transparency, nothing is visible in the background. When it's too much, the text is not visible. So good value is about 20%. So that's one way how you can put it. Or even better is to play a bit with more with the deck. Maybe try to squeeze the charts and create place for the for this bottom line message. And you can again add some icon over there to make it more attractive. So these would be my tips how to enhance charts graphically. Illustrate categories by icons, use the colors, remembering about visual hierarchy, and highlight key elements with special markers, and write the what's the message, what's the meaning of the chart. So there are other ways how you can enhance chart design further. You can create a legend manually, like create a legend which will look like this. So you can replace the default one. You can also play with a bar chart filling. So you can create a really creative looking bar chart like here with the paintbrush shapes. Or you can add some illustration on top, like over here, or embed bar chart inside some graphics.